You have been chosen. You, specifically you. You have been chosen. Have you seen kids getting chosen to share with a class or chosen to play on a team? Sports teams have drafts where they choose the best people to fit the needs of their teams. Large companies have hiring fairs and interviews to find the right employee for the job. Knowing they have been chosen can make a huge difference in someone's life. So I have some news for you. The God who created everything at the beginning of time, the God who is waiting at the end of time, the God who is in control right now at this time, that God chose you. Don't believe me? Let's see what the Bible has to say about that.
Ephesians 1:4, just as he chose us in him before the foundations of the world, that we would be holy and blameless before him in love.
He chose us before he even made the world? Now that's some planning. We were not picked at the last minute. You were not picked because you were the only one left. You were chosen from the very beginning of time. But that means my parents didn't choose God and I didn't actually choose God. God chose us, right?
Yes. John 15:16 says, "You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you, that you would go and bear fruit, and that your fruit would remain, so that whatever you ask of the Father in my name, he may give you." That's a pretty powerful promise.
Ah, I used to wonder, so why me? It took a while for me to understand that God is preparing each of us for a very specific work. Our situations and experiences are all different and all essential to the preparation towards the specific plan God has for us. What we each go through will be used by God to make us ready for our specific purpose.
Romans 8:28, "For we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God and to those who are called according to his purpose."
At work or school, we're surrounded by people who don't believe. These people are smart and successful. Why not choose them? Some of them are smarter and stronger or more popular or have newer phones and nicer clothes. Why not them?
Well, 1 Corinthians 1:27, "But God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong."
But sometimes I feel like we're the only ones. Look at everybody on social media. Most people seem to be doing their own thing. They're not preparing for a purpose. Why should we?
Well, Matthew 22:14, "For many are called, but few are chosen." And if you start to feel alone, don't forget you now have a bigger family to turn to. Ephesians 2:19, "So then you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and are of God's household."
So what are some of the roles in God's kingdom? The Bible describes apostles and prophets and teachers and helpers and administrators and givers and counselors and leaders and musicians and praisers. And the list goes on and on. Because anything that can be done to help and encourage people can be used for his kingdom. After all, God's kingdom is all about helping your neighbor. But we'll get more into specifics in our next lesson. Some may ask, am I too young to start getting ready for my life's purpose? What if I don't even know what God's purpose for me is yet?
Just because God hasn't yet revealed his whole plan for you doesn't mean you shouldn't step out yet. John 7:6, "Then Jesus said to them, my time has not yet come, but your time is always ready."
It sounds like we need to step out already. Even if you feel like God hasn't revealed his whole purpose for you yet, know this. You are here to proclaim God's goodness. Start there and watch what God does in your life.
1 Peter 2:9, "But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for God's own possession, so that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light."
So proclaim God's goodness. Share the good news today. After all, it is what you were chosen for.
And for that, we can say,
Thank you, Jesus. Bye, class.
We love you.
And we look forward to seeing you again soon.